Dear Diary, almost every night we sat on the dock for time on end watching the blue light, the centerpiece of a spiraling ecosystem. Far from the dulling ways of games and gadgets, we were captivated by the natural mystic of that other world. In the blue glow, we saw them dance, big as tarpon, small as shrimp, feeding and fleeing in the aquatic universe, dipping and darting from the darkness into the blue. And under the full moon sky, they delighted our senses, beckoning us to return night after night to the dry dock to wet our spirits on that watery blue. Off to bed we usually went, with our imaginations awake and our spirits full. Madassi to you, blue light. The pilot Island Stewards Camp, held in Stafford Creek, Andros, was an overwhelming success. This island-hopping summer experience targeted adolescent children living in the over-the-hill communities of New Providence. Too many of our children lack knowledge of their cultural traditions and are disconnected from the wholeness of the natural environment. They suffer from economic marginalization and view themselves as having little value. The Island Stewards Camp was designed to deepen our children's understanding of the country in which they live, strengthen their ability to function in it, and enhance their appreciation, love, and enjoyment of it. And enjoy it we did in Andros 2010. 8 volunteers and 2 observers oversaw the 15 stewards, ages 11 to 16 years, who participated in the 14-day pilot camp. One of the camp's greatest successes was the transformation experienced by the stewards in their relationship to the water. By the end of the camp, all of the stewards overcame some level of fear they previously had for the ocean. Most of them also demonstrated a marked improvement in their swimming ability. Stewards began each and every day at 6 a.m. with a swim at Blanket Sound Beach in one of 3 groups: swimmers, non-swimmers, and non-swimmers who were afraid of the water. By the end of the first week, 2 of the non-swimmers were moved to the swimmers group, and by the end of the camp, all of the stewards were comfortable in the water and had decreased their apprehension of jumping in. It became a regular base camp ritual for the stewards to jump in Stafford Creek from the dock's edge. The stewards even had the opportunity to take the same ride as the fish in Stafford Creek. Outfitted with life vests, the stewards jumped into the strong current of the creek. By floating and flowing with the current, they drifted down the creek, under a bridge, and out into the bay, finally landing on a distant beach. They learned how to use the energy of the water to travel from one point to another. They also learned how to use their hands and feet for direction.
Because the current started pushing fast.
Let's do it.
Surprised to see all them set. Yeah. I said they can't swim.
With Jeffrey and Anthony, how was the ride down?
It was good. When we reached the bridge, current was strong.
Very, very strong.
How about you, Anthony? And would you want to do it again?
That's what a lot. I do it plenty. If I have to, I'll do that every day.
Swimming was one of the many traditional marine-based skills that the stewards were exposed to. Others included boating and fishing. Our lead guide, Prescott, displayed his skills with a net after locating a school of bait fish. He caught a cooler full of pilchards to be used as bait on a fishing expedition. Camp volunteer Noelle Nichols was less successful in her attempts. Some stewards had the opportunity to captain the boats with guidance from volunteers. For others, it was a major accomplishment to simply ride a boat with little fear.
Sailor man sound, this is sailor man sound. Oh, this is sailor man sound.
Creek cleaning was another marine-based activity. Stewards spent an entire day in Fresh Creek, collecting debris from the shoreline. Stewards fashioned makeshift floats in an impromptu manner. They pulled the floats through the water and stacked them with the recovered debris that included tires, tennis shoes, glass bottles, metal cans, boating, and building materials. The stewards were blessed to experience firsthand blue holes similar to those featured on the cover of the August 2010 issue of National Geographic magazine, published just 1 week after the camp commenced. After some initial trepidation, the stewards could not get enough of swimming in the blue holes. They gained a personal understanding about the mystique of the blue holes and confronted some of the long-held myths associated with them. Camp activities also exposed stewards to a number of land-based skills, such as farming, thatching, and identifying medicinal plants. Stewards participated in a formal presentation on bush medicine, but this experience was enhanced by an unplanned meeting with native Androsians, who were harvesting pine bark, sperrit, and high nature bush on the side of the road. We stopped and engaged in an impromptu discussion with them. The stewards also combed through 1.5 miles of roadway in Andros, collecting debris. They collected cans and bottles to be recycled and disposed of the remaining debris in the public landfill. Non-redeemable bottles were used as aggregate in cement pavers. During the trip, we collected 50 cases of bottles that were redeemed for $100 and 300 pounds of aluminum cans, redeemed for $90. Stewards attended lectures by community elders and tradition keepers, such as Mr. Henderson Newton. He delivered a how-to program for roof thatching with bow-top palms that the stewards harvested under his direction. Everyone practiced tying the thatch on a roof frame. On several occasions, stewards participated in community walkabouts. Towards the end of the trip, stewards distributed departing gifts to many of the residents in Blanket Sound, our base settlement. The residents enthusiastically accepted our humble care packages, which consisted of unused foodstuffs, dry goods, hygiene supplies, and snacks. For many of the stewards, traveling to Andros was the first experience of being away from home. An urban city reality was all many of them knew of themselves and the Bahamas. When they returned, all of the stewards had a transformed understanding. The camp was a success, largely because of the support we received from our sponsors. For that, we would like to say Medassi, thank you. It truly took the community pulling together.
What does Harambe mean? Harambe means pulling together. And we've been doing Harambe since 13 years ago. And now you see what Harambe means, pulling together. We do that almost every afternoon at the after school program, pulling together. Harambe!
One!
Harambe!
Two!
Harambe!
Three!
Harambe!
Four!
Harambe!
Five!
Harambe!
Six!
The next camp is set to Island Hop to Ackland. Summer 2011 could not have come sooner enough. From August 3rd to 13th, Island Stewards will be based at the Ackland's Island Lodge, Mason's Bay. We cannot wait.
Them know they missing out, Mama Africa has
so much love to share.
Sweet blackness, oneness.
them know they missing out. Sing again. This for all the love and the life took away. Don't forget we were bought and traded. Ripped from the land and shipped away. It's the inspiration we use to survive. You have to see it with your own cry. Don't play, add it up and all right.